Pollution is one of the largest causes of death on the planet. It kills 9 million people a year. It's 1 in 6 deaths is attributable to pollution. Each of these circles is a number of deaths in a particular country from pollution. When you look at pollution in its totality, it's actually the largest cause of death on the planet. Pollution is 15 times larger cause of death in the world than violence, war, and terrorism. We quantify modern pollution deaths as being air pollution, chemicals and soil pollution, and pollution in the workplace. So adding all those together, you can see those deaths growing substantially. And this is the area where we have not put any attention. We've forgotten about this in our development agendas.
Modern pollution is mostly made up of what we call PM 2.5. Now the nomenclature comes from PM stands for particulate matter, and 2.5 means that particles are 2.5 microns in aerodynamic diameter or less. To give you an idea, that is 1/40th the diameter of a human hair. You can see spots in Africa, but take a look here at India, where you see the pollution pushing up against the mountains. And in China, it turns out that it's so small that when you breathe it in, it gets down into your lungs, and the consequences of that are increased mortality from heart disease and from respiratory disease. It comes from diesel exhaust, coal-fired power plants, and then these agricultural sources contributing to the overall burden of pollution. In the Los Angeles basin, we've been making measurements of air pollution in school kids, and as school kids grow, their lungs grow in that period, and as we cleaned up the air pollution in the LA basin, kids' lungs grew better.
Soil pollution is an issue that's just as substantive and just as problematic. So this data set here are places that my organization has identified where there are toxins at levels that far exceed safe standards in the soil. One of the problems that's out there is mercury. The biggest exposure we get from mercury is actually from gold miners. Artisanal gold miners, often working deep in the jungle, they'll grind up rock and then they pour in mercury. It will absorb the gold and they'll put a torch to it, a blowtorch to it. The mercury boils off and the gold magically appears. It leaves that mercury into the environment where it ends up in the rivers, it ends up in the ocean, the fish eat it, bioaccumulate it, and this is what ends up in our tuna fish. Even in very low concentrations, these things damage children's brains. Lead, mercury, some of the pesticides, and a whole slew of other chemicals. From the time of conception until about 5 years, these things will do permanent, irreparable damage to the brain structure. And there are so many simple solutions that small amounts of money can deal with and save the lives of millions, if not even billions of people around the world. On top of all these toxic sites, some of the examples of places where we've been able to go in and clean up these toxins and stop them from impacting local children. And we've done about 100 of these cleanups over the last 10 or 15 years, and they work. And for little money, they can do quite a lot of good. This is the site in Azerbaijan. It's a place that was contaminated by the chemicals industry and then abandoned. Cleaned up this piece of land here, about 2 hectares. The whole thing cost $100,000, and it went from being 800 times above the safe standards in terms of contaminant to well below. Last year, the US philanthropic private monies exceeded $350 billion. The amount that went into dealing with pollution and environmental health, $70 million. So we've forgotten about this problem.